Lead guitar, really, which is something that's my speciality, really. Like, you know, it's guitar solos that aren't really guitar solos, yeah. You know.
It's one of my favourite bits, yeah. Actually, where the lead guitar comes in.
I remember doing that like yesterday, and I had like sort of three or four stabs at it, and it was one of those things that I've got this reel really about guitar solos that they've got to be spontaneous. Because that translates to the record, I think, really. You can hear spontaneous and you can also hear stale. So each time I went in and did it, I was trying to sort of grasp for something that was a bit more. And there was that last one and it was just, I think that's it. And we came in and listened to it and it did its thing, really. It's, that was in a great shape. Out of all the songs that I heard, I thought what Tongi did on that, particularly the ambient stuff, I suppose people imagine... That's my bag, really, but it's probably Tongi's contribution, is it?
It was very the way that they mesh together the two guitars and that is a beautiful thing. And it's really, you didn't stamp on what he'd done. You didn't, no. you left what he'd done there. And
well, there was some talk of scrapping Tongi's stuff when I came back, and what he'd done on a lot of tracks was really tasteful, and he'd kind of. He'd orchestrated, I think, a little bit, really, and he'd probably orchestrated himself into the background. And then
it was a difficult task for him to come in. We were already established. He came in as our school friend and was, fill his boots kind of thing. That's a tough call because Nick's such an original player. It's not something you can
not something you'd want to do.
No, I want to do, yeah, why? You know, size are very different sort of player, but the way it worked was amazing. In fact, way before, you know, that happened with Nick leaving the and Si coming in, there was always talk of Simon coming at some point to help us out, because we were at sixth form college together, you know, and he was in bands that we were all in, so...
But isn't it, I mean, in the sleeve notes of the new version, which is out very soon, Nick, you say that Simon Tong taught you, Richard, how to play guitar. Really, so he was kind of, he's kind of involved somehow.
Exactly, he's always there on the periphery. Mm. Like when it was more of a case of when, really, you know, and he just came in such, I suppose, going that first tour to him must have just been like, what the hell is going on now? Mm. Like, you know what I mean? Because he'd never experienced just being on tour anyway.
Amazing.
Maybe I will love again. One day, maybe I will love again. sometime, sometime the way.